Hello everybody, and welcome to this week's update video. It's December, and it's time to do some arts and crafts, which means off with this hat, on with this hat, and let's get started. My name is Martin, and today I'm going to be showing you how to make an advent calendar using bits of card from the bin. So join me for Crafty Christmas Calendar. My daughter is 11 now, and she's getting a bit old for advent calendars. But when I came in with this bag of milk chocolate discs, her idea of making a calendar appealed to me greatly. Essentially, these are Chocosphere Corderia Paris 36% milk chocolate discs. And I've been getting a taste for trying out different kinds of chocolate. So I've been ordering these 5-pound bags to keep me going. And the chocolate discs that are available here are essentially the right kind of size that you would find in the British advent calendars produced by the likes of Cadbury's. And what I figured is that I would redo the tradition that I have on this channel of doing some arts and crafts for Christmas. So we start off by using a 2mm crisp packet box card. And we use a Brother Scan and Cut in order to cut and score the card so we're able to craft it into a new shape. I start off in the free program Inkscape, and I make a box of the size of the hole that will contain the chocolate. Next, I add lines to indicate the walls and the flaps of the design. I've coloured the cutting lines in red and the folding lines in green so I can better see what I'm going to send to the Scan and Cut. The idea for this design is that each hole will fold in on itself like a concertina, turning this once 2D material into a 3D object punched into a single sheet of card. Next, the waste card between each hole is turned into a flap that can be folded down to provide extra rigidity, as well as creating extra sides in the hole to keep the chocolate from sliding out. I was recently reminded how important it is to make a test run. I had no idea if this design would actually work, so I needed to get a bit of scrap card back out of the bin and set up a test cut. Next, I set the depth of the cutting blade for each of the two steps. If the setting is too high, the blade will go through the card and damage the design mat behind it. If it's too low, then it won't go all the way through and you won't be able to get the design out. So I chose setting 9 for cutting and setting 4 for scoring the fold lines. These settings are actually quite high for this machine, but the card is quite thick. Putting this sample together was quite fiddly, but I was eventually able to get it to fold in the way I had imagined it should. I learned two important things from this test. Firstly, it was way too small. In my excitement, I'd forgotten to actually measure one of the buttons, and as you can see, I was going to have to increase the size. Secondly, was that the fold lines folded in two different directions, but my score lines were only on one side of the card, making some folds easy and others very hard. If I wanted this process to be easier, I'd have to score both sides of the card, but this is actually very hard to do. Next, I took a break.
Right, back to work then.
Back in Inkscape, I applied what I'd learned and created a full sheet of holes. Each hole's flaps are connected, so unfortunately nothing will pling out as it's being cut. But because of the new size, I was only able to fit 20 holes in the sheet and not the usual 24. This wouldn't be a problem, as some days can be the surprising gift of unpredictability, an important life lesson and a terrible excuse for bad maths. Rather than run another test, I decided to just commit to the design that I had. One of the reasons why I like using this machine is because it accepts SVGs directly, so I don't need to do any painful conversions in order to get it out of Inkscape and into the machine. There is, however, a problem. The designs that you send to the machine are not aligned with each other, so you have to manually position them by eye on the tiny LCD panel. This is unfortunate, as there's plenty of information in the SVG file to know exactly where to place the designs. The next step was actually the hardest and the most time-consuming. Basically, 20 little doors were in the test was quite fiddly to do one. I now had to go row by row, column by column, and poke every single one of them out. Once poked, I used tape to secure the backing. Each of the flaps had to be stuck down, and each of the overlaps had to be reconnected. I actually had to poke them all out at the same time, as they would each interfere with each other, stopping you being able to fold the whole thing until the whole row was complete. After a lot of cutting and folding, I had a completed sheet of holes. I made sure that the chocolates would fit by filling them all right away, giving me a pleasing array and a sense of accomplishment. But this project isn't done yet. We need to stick a sheet of 1mm card over the top of the holes. I'm using an old manila folder as cardstock. Back in Inkscape, I designed two new layers with the same dimensions as the hole design, but this time with the flap heights removed from the original height, as this height has been converted to depth. The first layer is the doors themselves. I start with a rectangle of the right size and remove one of its sides. I set the stroke pattern to a long dashed line and then use the dash to stroke extension to convert these dashes into cutting strokes. Next, I create a pen design. This is like printing, but using a pen instead. Each stroke of the pen corresponds to a stroke in Inkscape, so everything must be converted to a stroke. I add some holly for a festive hint to the numbers that I position over each of the doors. But since the pen is only one colour, I don't add any other designs, as this wouldn't look very good. I send the design to the same machine I used for cutting, but this time with a pen in the holder instead of a knife. Drawing and then cutting on the same sheet allows me to keep good registration. In production, registration is when you have multiple processes that have to line up. This can be different inks in a colour print, or in this case, inking and cutting steps. This is actually why scoring the underside of the backing card was so hard. Trying to achieve orientation, let alone perfect alignment, is notoriously difficult with consumer-grade machinery. The final steps was to colour in using some coloured pencils, and sticking it to the backing card using regular paper glue. It's important that I stuck the card down on top of the chocolates, as there'd be no way to get them out or put them in after the glue had dried without breaking the perforations. And just like that, here we have it. You can see it's rattling because the chocolates are now stuck inside. I've glued it all down and it's going to set overnight. But as you can see, I think we've done a pretty good job. It looks pretty sturdy, although, you know, sellotape. I wish there was some way of making the card fold in to each other, but I just didn't have enough time to be able to calculate little tabs that kind of slide into each other. Though it is theoretically possible to make it so that it kind of snaps together better. And as I said, I think if I was able to score both sides of the card, the folds would actually be more natural and it would probably concertina in a much more natural way. But I think this is actually pretty good. It's you know, it's exactly what you might expect if somebody was to make their own. And using the machine has definitely saved me a lot of time when it comes to all of the fiddly bits. No satisfying little plings of card, unfortunately, you know, with the little personal knives. But I was fiddling with it like an awful lot, so I think that counts. And thank you for joining me for this video. I hope you've had fun watching me do some arts and crafts, and maybe it's inspired you to be able to create some of your own physical things for your family for the holiday season. I'll see you next week for a regular video, and thank you for sharing my videos and subscribing and everything else that you guys do. And I hope you have a very good Advent. Until next time.